الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وحده في ذاته ووحده في صفاته وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا فصلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فقد قال تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في سورة البقرة بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون صدق الله مولانا العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقده من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Ramadan, the month of blessings. Ramadan is the best month because of the many blessings it has. It is the month of fasting and taqwa. It is the month of al-Quran, grace, rahmah, mercy and compassion. It is the month of patience and perseverance. It is the month of ad-du'a, repentance and forgiveness. It is the month of charity and looking after the poor and the needy. It is the month of gratitude. It is the month of ibadah, worship. Ramadan combines all these blessings. Every single good deed performed during this great month is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having the proper sincere niyyah. We fast out of obedience to Allah and with absolute sincerity. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykum siyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. O believers, O you who believe, fasting had been ordained upon you just as it was ordained upon those who came before you. Fasting, like salah, zakat, and hajj, is a mode of worship. The Prophet, in a profound hadith, an Abdullah bin Umar bin al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, said, قَالَ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ بُنِيَ الْإِسْلَامُ عَلَى خَمْسِ. Islam is built on five. Those are the so-called pillars of Islam. شهادتي أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله الشهادتان. To bear witness that there is no God except Allah and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة. To establish the daily prayers and to give زكاة. وحج البيت وصوم رمضان. To go for pilgrimage and to fast in the month of Ramadan. Each mode of worship has a purpose and goal. The purpose of fasting is taqwa, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. It is to attain taqwa, to remain conscious of Allah. The goal is to learn self-restraint, to abstain from unlawful and sinful acts, no matter how much our souls desire the unlawful and sinful acts. It is to become aware of and honor the divine injunctions of do's and don'ts. It is a form of training on obedience. Abstaining from food, drink, and other desires is a step toward achieving piety. Fasting helps us control our baser self and suppress our ego. The nafs, the lower nafs, and nafs al-ammara bisu, the nafs that entices us to commit evil. Fasting is a physical, moral, and spiritual discipline. Fasting is a well-known tradition of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As a well-known tradition of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that diet control is the best cure for many diseases, a fact that has been recently proven by medical findings. Is it any wonder the Prophet ﷺ used to fast Mondays and Thursdays and on other occasions? Fasting elevates our morals, helps us abstain from vain talk and any frivolous activities and behavior. Fasting helps us increase our faith in Allah. It strengthens our bond and connection with Him. We become more conscious and aware of Him, thus increasing our deeds in return for His pleasure, mercy, and forgiveness. Ramadan is a holy month because the Holy Quran was sent in Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. It is the month where the Quran was sent down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from al-lawh al-mahfuz. We fast during the day and stand shoulder to shoulder in prayers at night, honoring and commemorating the revelation of the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. It is guidance, هدى للناس, guidance to all people for all time to come. It is بينات من الهدى. It is clear, absolutely clear. The Quran gives you guidance, and the evidence comes from our very own nature. It is in line with our fitrah. It is al-furqan, بينات من الهدى والفرقان. Al-furqan, the Quran that separates between good and evil, truth and falsehood, haqq and batil. It distinguishes between right and wrong. The eternal guidance has been granted to all mankind. هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ. It is God's final gift to humanity. How honored and privileged are we to be the recipients of Allah's last scripture, His final words. Ramadan is a month of spiritual training. It is the month of taqwa. Taqwa is the driving force to ihsan. Ihsan, as defined by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is بِأَن تَعْبُدَ رَبَّكَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِن لَمْ تَكُن تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. To worship Allah as if you are seeing Him, and in the event you don't have that realization, do know that He is seeing you. Our motive and intention is to remain conscious of Allah. Both the inner drive and outer action are required. The inner desire to revere, worship, and obey Allah is taqwa. This innate desire to love and adore Allah, this fitrah that is within us, must be nurtured and raised to the level of the most beautiful worship to Allah, and that is ihsan. Ramadan gives us that opportunity to advance and raise our souls to that of a contented soul, and nafsul mutma'innah. To have taqwa is to have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on your side all the times, day and night, alone and in public, at work and at home, wherever you may be. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. Indeed, Allah is with those who are conscious of Him and do good. A conscious believer who inadvertently sins is quick to atone his sin by seeking forgiveness from Allah and following it up with a good deed. Ramadan is the month of good deeds. Ramadan is the month of dua, repentance, and forgiveness. True and sincere servants of Allah ask for contentment, satisfaction of the heart, tranquility, and that their actions here in this world deliver them from the painful punishment of hell. Allah promised that He will answer their plea and that He will grant them their request. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. When my servants ask you concerning me, tell them I am very near. I will respond to them. I will respond to the call of the caller so long he calls on me. Ad-du'a is a form of ibadah. It is the essence of ibadah, worship. In a hadith, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ad-du'a'u mukhul ibadah. Du'a is the essence of ibadah. And in another narration, narrated by An-Nu'man ibn Bashir radiyallahu anhu, he said, I heard the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, Ad-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah. Thumma qal, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, dua is the ibadah. الدُّعَاءُ هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ. And he quoted the ayah from Surah Al-Ghafir, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي. And your Lord said, call on me, أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. I will respond to your call. I will respond to your dua. Surely those who are too proud to call on me will enter hell humiliated. God-conscious believers call on Allah and Allah alone for all their needs, worldly and otherwise. One of the occasions where Allah responds to the dua and accepts the dua of His servant is at time of breaking the fast. Abdullah bin Amr radiyallahu anhuma qala sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul lis-sa'imi 'inda iftarihi da'watun mustajaba. Abdullah bin Amr said, I heard the Messenger of Allah say, at the time of breaking the fast, the fasting person has a supplication, a du'a, which is accepted. And you know what Abdullah bin Amr used to supplicate? He used to gather his family before breaking the fast. And then he will make a supplication. Allahumma inni as'aluka bi rahmatika allati wasi'at kulla shay'in an taghfira li. Forgiveness. He says, he would supplicate and say, oh Allah, I ask you by your mercy, which extends to every single thing, that you would forgive me, that you would forgive me. Another excellent dua, very dear to the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhaban nar. Our Lord, give us good in this life and also good in the hereafter, and save us from the punishment of hell. May Allah save us from the torment of hell. Allahumma Ameen. This dua combines both worldly needs and the need for the akhirah, for Jannah, for forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You may invoke Allah and supplicate on anything you want, on anything you need. Good health, good halal provision, maghfirah, Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared heaven and paradise only for those who are conscious of Him, those who have taqwa. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَّبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And hasten to forgiveness from your Lord. This is the month to ask for forgiveness. اللهم اغفر لي. اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم أقوم الحساب. One of the most beautiful du'as. Forgiveness. And hasten to forgiveness from your Lord and a garden as vast as the heavens and the earth, prepared, u'iddat lilmuttaqeen, to the God-conscious believers. Ramadan is the month of patience, forbearance, self-control, and tolerance. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah, inna Allaha ma'as-sabirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the believers that they should seek help through patience and prayers. Ramadan came to cleanse our hearts and purify our souls, to have our sins forgiven and to be freed from the hellfire. Ramadan is meant to strengthen our willpower and help us to control our shahawat, worldly desires. Patience is required as we refrain from food and drink and marital relations during the blessed month. Allah has instilled in us many desires, and at the same time, He set for us certain boundaries to be guarded. Anyone who crosses the boundaries has sinned. It requires patience to remain in the domain of what is lawful and what is permissible, what is halal. Just as we are required to remain patient while fasting long hours, we are required to remain patient on unlawful things, no matter how much our souls desire them. Patience is one of the requirements of our deen. Our deen is built on patience. Keeping your gaze under control requires patience. Safeguarding your ear and filtering out all sinful speeches and songs requires patience. Refraining from foul language requires patience. Avoiding indulgence in unlawful and sinful acts requires patience. It is not easy. For this reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed the believers to always seek help through patience and prayers. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah. Inna Allaha ma'as-sabirin. O believers, seek help through patience and prayers. Indeed, Allah is with the patient ones. Inna Allaha ma'as-sabirin. Patience is a fundamental aspect of our deen. We exercise it while fasting. We must always practice it. Ista'inu bis-sabr. Sabr is coupled with gratitude. Inna fi dhalika la ayatin likulli sabbarin shakur. Verily, in this there are signs for those who are firmly patient and constant, grateful and appreciative. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he used to say, Al-Imanu nusfan. Iman is two halves. Nisfu sabrin wa nisfu shukr. Half of it is patience and the other half is gratitude. Being thankful to Allah. Allahumma rzuqna sabra wa shukr. Allahumma ameen. Patience is coupled with tawakkul. Alladhina sabaru wa ala rabbihim yatawakkaloon. They are the ones who are steadfast, patient, and put their trust in their Lord. It is also used with taqwa. وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. If you are patient and mindful of Allah, that is a sign of real resolve and determination. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us patience, taqwa, forgive our sins and accept our ibadah during this blessed month. Allahumma ameen. Aqul qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'il muslimin wal muslimat fastaghfiruh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Was salatu was salam ala sayyidil mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa ba'd. Brothers and sisters, Ramadan is the month, among other things, the month of charity and looking after the poor and the needy. Muslims follow the tradition of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet was very generous, and he was more generous in the month of Ramadan. وَكَانَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَجْوَدُ مَا يَكُونَ فِي شَهْرِ رَمَضَانِ. Believers give more during Ramadan because they believe what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said: charity never decreases wealth. ما نقص مال من صدقة. Rather, it increases it. Yes, it increases it. And because they know the enormous rewards they receive when they give. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة The example of those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah is like a seed of grain which grows 7 years. In each year is 100 grains. So do the math. 700. And not only that, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give more than 700 times to whomever He wills. Who are those individuals whom Allah will give more? He will give more to those individuals, particularly those who may not have much, but are sincere and are devout believers with taqwa, and they give for the pleasure and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He will give them and give them. He will give whomever He wills. The key thing here is to, when you give, be sincere in your charity. Not that you should follow whatever you have given with mannan aw adhan, meaning that you have made a favor to them. It's not a favor that you are making to those whom you are giving. Rather, you are giving it for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The charity in Ramadan is better than the charity at any other time, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called Ramadan shahrul muwasat. This is the month of charity, the month of help and support and relief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His infinite wisdom gives some people wealth and restricts wealth to others. For example, you have in this ayah al-mubarakah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِنَّ رَبِّي يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. We need to understand how Allah works when it comes to wealth. First of all, we do know that what we have is not our wealth, is not our possession. What we have is the wealth of Allah. وَآتُوهُمْ مِنْ مَالِ اللَّهِ الَّذِي أَتَاكُمْ. Give them, give charity from the wealth of Allah, the man of Allah that He has given you. So we have to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His own wisdom, He gives plenty to some people and He restricts to others. So say, O Prophet, surely my Lord gives abundantly to whom He wills and restricts it to whom He wills. But most people don't understand this. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. To understand His wisdom, Allah informed us that wealth is a fitna, a trial, a test for us. وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةٌ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ أَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. Indeed, do know, O people, that your wealth and your children are nothing but a trial, a test for you. And do know that with Allah rests a great reward. Allah is testing us to see if He or she will share His or her wealth with the poor and needy, those whom Allah had restricted their wealth. By the same token, Allah is testing those whom Allah had restricted wealth from them. Will they resort to haram means for their livelihood? This is explained in Surah Al-Fajr. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا. The nature of man is that when his Lord tries him through honor and blessings, provision, wealth, he says, oh, my Lord has honored me. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا. And when his Lord tests him and gives him little wealth, little provision, then he says, my Lord, my Allah has humiliated me, dishonored me. What is the response of Allah regarding such attitude from both the wealthy and the poor? Kalla bal la tukrimuna al-yatim. But nay, O people, consider all that you do and fail to do. You are not generous toward the orphan. وَلَا تَحَاضُّونَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينَ. And you not urge one another to feed the needy. وَتَأْكُلُونَ التُّرَاثَ أَكْلًا لَمَّا. And you devour the inheritance of yours with devouring greed. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. And you love wealth immensely. You love wealth immensely. You have extreme love of wealth. And this is true. Allah is exposing our nature toward wealth. Is this not man's nature? Yes, Allah spoke the truth. We love wealth. We love to be rich. There is nothing wrong in getting rich as long as, number one, you earn it through halal, permissible means. And number two, you share it with others. Nothing wrong with that. Make sure your earnings is halal. And make sure that you share it. There are others whom Allah had restricted, had not given what Allah had blessed you with. Share that wealth with them. One of the signs of a true muttaqi is that he spends out of what Allah gave him. This is in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. Alif Lam Mim, Dhalika Al-Kitabu La Rayba Fihi Hudan Lil-Muttaqin. The book of Allah is guidance to the righteous, pious, God-fearing people like you and me and the believers and the Muslims who are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But who are they? الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. They believe in the unseen. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. They establish the daily prayer. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And they spend out of what we have provided for them. You will never attain righteousness, my dear brothers and sisters, unless you spend from that which is dear to you, wealth. لِقَوْلِهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. Never will you attain righteousness until you spend from that which you love. وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ. Whatever you spend, indeed Allah knows it. He's aware of what you are spending because He wants to replace it for you. He wants to multiply it for you. He wants to increase it as you spend and save in the universal bank of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One day you will see how much you have invested in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will give you the ultimate reward, and that is heaven, paradise, jannatin tajri min tahtiha al-anhaar, wasari'u ila maghfiratin min rabbikum, wa jannatin arduha as-samawati wal-ard, u'iddat lil-muttaqin. Hasten to forgiveness from your Lord, and the jannah, as vast as the heavens and the earth, prepared for the righteous people who spend from that which they love. But who are those righteous people? الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. They spend in times of prosperity and in times of hardship. Even when they don't have enough, they still spend in the path of Allah because they know, if I spend, even if I don't have it, I know Allah is going to provide for me and give me more. And it works. Believe me, it works. Try it. Try it, but not testing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we cannot test Allah. Allah will test us, but we can't test Allah. Try it with utmost sincerity and see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. Those are acts of ihsan and kindness. Let us in this great month practice those good habits. Spend in times of ease and in times of difficulties and hardship. Spend willingly and out of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah promised that He will replace it for you. وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. Whatever you spend, a penny, a dollar, $100, $1,000, $10,000, whatever you spend, Allah said, فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ. Do you believe Allah? فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ. He will replace it for you. وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. He is the best of the providers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us in this great month to fulfill all the ibadat, everything from fasting to qiyam, to reciting the Quran, to supplication, to giving in charity, And may Allah accept all of our good deeds we perform in this blessed month. Inshallah ta'ala, Allahumma ameen. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim. Wa barakallahu li wa lakum fi hadha al-shahr al-azim. اللهم آمين إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم عنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين ومن عبادك المخلصين ومن عبادك المتقين وارحمنا في هذا الشهر العظيم إنك على كل شيء قدير وصلى الله على خير خلقه محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين